Alam mo, folks, there are 11 major organizations in DepEd of employees and teachers, non-teaching. At itong dalawang organization na ito constitute, as of our latest count, about 10% of 847,000 mga employees and mga staff. At itong mga organisasyon na ito ay mga lehitimong organisasyon. Ang mga lehitimong organisasyon, hindi naman sila underground. So they have to register. At saka requirement yan ng law na kung mag-register ang isang organization, lalo na for bargaining purposes, lalo na for negotiation purposes, eh requirement yan ng SEC na mag-submit ng listahan ng pangalan ng mga miyembro. That is a standard requirement which we require all organizations, whether it's the Association of Nurses Spokes, the Association of Dentists, the Association of Lawyers. We have an Association of Lawyers right there in DepEd. Lahat sila nagre-register, and especially those na who are engaged in negotiation. Hindi naman underground organizations itong dalawang sinasabi natin mga organisasyon. They are open organization. As open organizations, of course, they are expected to submit the list of their members. It is standard, which is expected of all those who want to be recognized. And also, may mga dialogues, may mga issues, kailangan talagang malalaman. All, furthermore, itong mga organisasyon na ito, nagko-collect spokes ng membership fees which we collect for these particular organizations. So kailangan malaman namin yung mga miyembro kung saan dinideduct namin yung kanilang mga membership fees. These are standard. Hindi naman illegitimate itong mga organisasyon na ito. They're perfectly legitimate, and therefore they are perfectly required by law to submit what is usually required of legitimate organizations which deal with the government. Kasi magko-collect kami ng membership fees, magko-collect kami ng kung anong mga payments, etc. Nagne-negotiate kami. So, it's normal. The dentists negotiate with us. The nurses negotiate with us. The lawyers, of course, you can expect them. They're negotiating with us very frequently. Even the clerks negotiate with us. And they are all expected to comply with the requirements of law. But then Yusek Nepo, probably because he's a lawyer, can explain it better. Ulitin ko, these organizations na sinasabi ninyo ay legitimate, and therefore they are subject to the legitimate requirements of law on organizations. Nepo, baka mas magaling kang magsalita.
Yes. Secretary Briones, Yusek Raki, we would like to assure organizations and teachers within the Department of Education na walang ginagawang individual profiling ang Department of Education. Ang kanilang mga individual data and information are all part of the official records that we keep in relation to their employment in the Department of Education. Itong personal data sheet, for example, that we keep of all of our teachers, personnel, and officials are part of the requirements for their qualifications, their assignments, as well as their career progression. And we keep this we safeguard this information. We have a data protection officer in the Department of Education. And so any disclosure or sharing of this information comply with data protection. So there is no individual profiling that the department is doing outside of the required submission of information. As mentioned by the secretary, we do have an interest to know let's say for example, the membership and no number in terms of number of the membership of the different organizations, because we also need to know how representative they are of what they claim to represent, and as part of, for example, processes such as negotiation or the collective negotiation with any of these representative organizations. Maraming salamat.